Hey everybody, I wanted to talk to you for a moment about why we need church. You know, when I was growing up and I got connected to a church, a lot of times people would be berated for not coming. It was the idea that you had to come to church, and I literally actually had somebody tell me one time, listen, if you quit going to church and it gets easier for you to not go the next week and the next week and the next week, and finally you're not going at all. And that was often the type of mentality that people had, that the church became a habit. And so what often happened is church was something that you went to, not something that you did. It wasn't who you were, it was what you did. And what it did is it gave way to an entire performance-based Christianity that wasn't, at its very foundation and core, about grace. See, here's the thing. The reason why God created the church, and he did, he ordained the church, he ordained the family first, then he ordained the church, was so that we would have a sense of community. I want you to think about it. Family gives us a sense of community. It gives a sense of independence, but also interdependence. It's a place where we learn, where we grow, where we support, where we encourage, where we launch. And so church is supposed to be the same thing. But often what happens is people come to church, they have a worship experience, or they come, they sing, they hear the Bible, they shake hands, they say hello to each other at the greeting time or at the sign of peace time, whatever church it is you go to, they call it different things. But then they're gone, and no sense of community is built. Now, people try to force that, by the way. They try to force community by forcing Sunday school classes or forcing small groups or having some type of a fellowship time with coffee or having some type of a dinner, things like that. And all of those things are really, really good if the idea is you are building community. See, because here's the thing. People that are out there today need community. They need a place to get connected. And I like to say that's what we're about at Community Bible Church. We're simply about connecting people to God through Jesus Christ, connecting people to one another, and connecting to our community. But I want to tell you something, and I'm being really, like, I'm always honest with you, but I'm being brutal about this. We're not connecting. We're not connecting the way that we need to. And so we are really going to begin working hard at connecting one another and creating that sense of community. That's why tomorrow I'm going to be speaking on the topic, Better Together. We actually need one another in each other's lives. It's not just about people that we know and hanging out with them, but it is literally fostering connections with people that God has brought together. There are so many stories of people in our church, so many different stories of people that have overcome cancer, people that have lost loved ones, people that have struggled with the loss of businesses and jobs. We have business owners, and we have workers, and we have retired people, and we have pilots, and we have entrepreneurs. We have so many different types of people in our church, but often I don't know that we know one another and that we take the time to more than just shake hands and say hello, and then we kind of go out the door. So tomorrow, I want to talk about why we are better together and exactly what it is that the church is supposed to be. Not do, but be. See, here's the thing. If we create community the way that we need to among ourselves, we are then, by default, going to go out and reach out to the other community. In fact, our outside community is going to stop. They're going to look and go, what is going on at Community Bible Church? We want what they have. And it's because we would be loving one another the way that Jesus wants us to love one another. So if you're really interested in building community and you want a new start at connecting, I want you to come, even if you've been to Community Bible Church before, I want you to come tomorrow. I want you to come, and we're going to be talking from a passage of scripture that I don't even want to tip my hat, if I had a hat on right now, and tell you what it is, because it was used for years to berate people into going to church. But I think when we take a look at it tomorrow, you're going to see something totally different. So don't stay away. Tomorrow is the day of all days for you and I to come together. So I can't promise you, that we're going to have lights and all of those kinds of things that you may see in another church, but I will promise you, we're going to talk about truly what it means to be a community and how to be connected to one another, because that's the mission and that's the vision that God has given us. So we'll see you tomorrow at Community Bible Church. Make sure you share this with your friends. Once again, we're located 1 mile west of I-95, 1 mile east of 441 at the corner of Griffin Road and Southwest 30th Avenue. We start at 10:30 a.m. Now, let me tell you, can you experience us online? Absolutely. And if you can't get out to the church, then by all means, experience us online. But there's nothing like being there. So we'll see you tomorrow.